destroy all strategies, all ideas to make sure that everybody becomes successful. Yes, we will continue with all our radio program and we'll add more radio. Now, we'll also add this one. All our jingles, all our interview, every member will have it. What are you going to do with it? You will send it to every of your contact on WhatsApp, to your contact on Instagram, to your contact on Facebook. Now, the first time I did a seminar, I used a hall at Meron. I didn't go to radio. I did an interview. I sent to some people. I said, help me send to at least 10 or 20 of your contacts. I said, help me send to 10 or 20 of your contacts. And they did that. Just one time. For that seminar, I had over 100 people. Would that go to radio? Would that go to radio? So, we are going to also implement that idea. We are going to implement that strategy. Therefore, every one of us, we must make sure that our WhatsApp is working and functional. So that as we are coming up with various jingles, various interviews about our business, we'll be sending to us individually. What do you send to everybody on your podcast? Many will ask me, this is just you know, what do I do this day? Attend the seminar. I will be able to meet me there. Imagine if you have 5 or 10 or 20 of your contacts that came to attend, and some of them joined. And together with those who are putting under you from radio, what is happening to your business? It is growing. 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 So, I have personally quite a number of strategies that we're going to deploy this year. Because if the business lacks innovation, it will not go anywhere. If the business lacks innovation, it will not go anywhere. Now let me tell you something. There have been banks before GTB and Zenith Bank. That's again. We had banks like Weber Bank, First Bank, Union Bank. Can you compare Union Bank and GTB now?
No.
Can you compare Union Bank and Zenith Bank? No. What has happened? Innovation. Those banks, they just sat down here. They have enough customers already. But all these new banks, because the people at the heads of Afia, they are known men with intelligence. So they are looking at how to penetrate the markets. Why do you sit down and wait for customers to come and meet you? They send their own marketers to the markets. They send their marketers everywhere, to various offices. Before now, that did nothing like that. If you want to open an account in the bank, it's you that will go to the bank by yourself. But they said, no, stay where you are. We will send marketers to come and meet you. Grab money. Where is that? Before, if you want to withdraw money in the bank, if you are using Union Bank and Kegbeda, you cannot withdraw at Union Bank and anything. They will say, go to Union Bank and Kegbeda. That is where they have your record. But when these new banks came in, the likes of GTB, the likes of Zenith Bank, the likes of Access, they said, what is the deal of that? You can withdraw your money anywhere. Nigeria said, no, it's not possible. It's not possible. They said, you go here if you do not see your money. Nobody's asking, go to a better, go to Biloko. You are getting your money wherever you are. Nigeria said, that's fine. People were closing their accounts in those banks. We are moving their money to the new banks. Innovation is what drives business. Innovation is what grows business. You might be intelligent. You might know how to talk. You might be focused and committed, but if you lack innovation, you will know where you are. You will remain where you are. Therefore, this year, by the grace of God, we have a lot of things we are bringing on board, a lot of things. I will just plead with us, let us be functional on WhatsApp. Why? Because a lot of these things we send to us on WhatsApp, and I will give us how to do it. Send this to your contacts, send this to this, send this to that, send this to this, send this to that. Then our Zoom will be going on Facebook Live with our Zoom. So as your Facebook, share with everybody you know on Facebook. Just share. And once you share, all your contacts on Facebook will see our business live. Yes. I got a woman from Florida late last year. From Florida. It was on Facebook Live. One of my contacts, I was doing Zoom. And I said, sir, can I connect to your glass? Why not? And somebody called and said, can you, what you are presenting, can you send to me? I said, why not? Send your email. And she did. And I sent this slide to her by mail. The third day she called and said, how can I transfer the money to Nigeria? I know what this business is. So, you can see that there are a lot of ways we can grow our business. Now, networking is an investment in your business. Not in my business, not in our business, but in your business. Many of us do not consider this business as their business. They see it as my online business. When you consider it as your business, every day you'll be checking your accounts if money has entered. Every day you'll be thinking, how can I get more money? Take this business as your only source of income. On Thursday, I told those that were here, I said, this year, assume that you don't have any other means of survival. This is the only thing you have. I'm sure you don't play with this. And they said, of course. Yes, you have other businesses that are giving you money. But every of your business, take them as the only business. Take them as the only business. Every of your business, take them as the only business. Now, something happened last week. Welcome, ma'am. Something happened last week. One man called me on the phone. He said, can I meet with you? I said, yes. I said, who are you, sir? He mentioned his name. He said, I don't know you, sir. He said, I was in one of your seminars in November. I said, well, I am putting up an office at the bed. I have prepared all this while, even throughout December. He said, ah, no, I cannot come to Ekweda. The Ekweda is okay because I live at Mowin. I said, okay, sir, we fixed appointments. And I went to meet with him. He came with his wife that day. He sat down at the river's office to discuss. The man said something. He said, when I did the seminar, he really showed the plan of this business. I fell in love with it. But the money I was expecting had not come. When the money came, I said, let me come with my wife. The same way you told us, tell us now, no, my wife can hear. And I gave him the seminar. The wife said, impressive. He said, I'm a pastor. Now, I am ready for this business together with my wife. How can I build this business? I said, very simple. Number one, through radio. Subscribe to our radio program. Number two, talk to a few people that can invite you to present the business to them. Maybe in a church. Maybe in your office. You belong to a cooperative association in the market. Talk to them. It doesn't cost you anything. I will not charge you money. I will collect 1 naira. I'll travel outside the country without collecting anything. I'll be to Ojiriba, anywhere. I'm asking your people without collecting a dime from anybody. Yes. I say I will not collect anything from you. Even though I book my hotel myself, your own is that arrange a meeting for me. Let people catch up and come and deliver to them. He said, okay, that's good. And we'll discuss and we'll let. Already the account number of the company. The following day in the morning, which was today, Saturday, I did on Tuesday of this week, just called me, said, he has transferred $1 million. To a global account. He said, do 7 accounts for my wife. Do 7 accounts for me. His name is Pastor Ike. He said, the remaining money, I want to use it to do radio program. Then I'm working on various organizations that we can take this business to. Just give me 2 weeks. You'll be tired. Now,
And I said, sir, he's a pastor. He's a pastor. He said, let me tell you something. I am not the kind of pastor that waits on members' offering. No. I'm not the kind of pastor that waits on members' tithes. No. So, while some members, they are on the mountain, they are praying, they are in the church, they are praying, your pastor is taking a decision about his life and that of his family.